How to use a vacuum erection device. This is Jared J. Wallen, MD, board certified urologic surgeon and men's sexual health specialist. You and we, urologic surgery and wellness. You can find us at www.youandwe.com or 941-212-1600, Sarasota, Florida. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is Jared J. Wallen, MD, board-certified urologic surgeon and men's sexual health specialist. We're coming to you today from sunny Sarasota, Florida, talking about how to use the vacuum erection device. It's a common question that I get from patients. It's a common question that I get online. You know, what is a vacuum erection device? How to use it? When do you recommend it? I do have another video on the YouTube channel talking about all the 7 common treatments for erectile dysfunction. There is a short little synopsis, but I wanted to make this short video so that way you can easily access it if you need a reminder or if you wanted more information than that provided. Again, that's a quick adage to like and subscribe to the YouTube video, share it with friends, increase our visibility so more patients like yourself or more providers like yourself, more physicians like yourself can find the content and find value. That's what we're here for, is to provide you value, help you live your best life, and help you help your patients to the fullest. So the vacuum erection device, what it is, remember, the penis is essentially a little inflatable rod. You need good blood flow in to fill it up. You need little valves to close to trap that blood there. That gives you the stiffness to be able to participate in activities. So the vacuum erection device is essentially an option for folks who are either failing medications or don't have other options that they can use for treatment, again, as we described in that other YouTube video. So if you fail oral medications, because that's usually the first line other than behavioral interventions, then the vacuum erection device is one of the other many options that can help you. And we'll talk about 2 main uses. One is for activities. The other is for penile rehab in the setting of either severe erectile dysfunction or certainly a post-surgical intervention for the pelvis. So this is a vacuum erection device. It's essentially an elongated cylinder that basically functions just like a vacuum. It's a negative pressure device which pulls force into the cylinder to basically inflate and pull blood into the penis and kind of recreate that inflow activity that we typically talk about with the inflation of the rod. There is also, remember, we talked about not only the inflation of the rod, but the little trapping of blood there. That's what this little ring is for. And this is called basically a penile ring or a restriction band or what have you. It's just a little rubber thing. I do also recommend a third little element here, and that's a bottle of lubrication. You're going to use that, number one, to kind of make it easier to slide this little ring on and off. But number two, to kind of coat the little edge end of this cylinder. So that way it gets a better seal on your skin when you're trying to use this little device. We'll talk about first how to use this device for activities. So first thing you're going to do is flip the little cylinder upside down after you've put some lube on the ring and on the end of the cylinder. Basically just slide the little ring on the end of the cylinder like so. And then what you're going to do is find the penis, slide the little band and cylinder over the top of the penis. This one is battery operated. And so basically what you're going to do is you're going to, you know, make sure it's sealed on the skin here, you know, and then push the button. What that's going to do is that's going to increase blood flow and pull blood into the penis, stretch the penis out. And with that negative pressure that the vacuum is creating. So what you're going to do is do that until your penis is full. And then again, if you're doing this for activities, you want to keep that seal all the way, but then basically you're just going to slide the little restriction band off the end of here and to the end of the penis. And again, what that does is after you've filled the penis up, what this does is traps the blood there so that way you can participate in activities. Sometimes folks don't always love to use that for activities because if you think about, you know, this as the elongated rod, remember half of your penis is inside your pelvis, half of your penis is external. And so if you put that little restriction band there, basically it creates a little fulcrum here where basically you can pivot and kind of, you know, lose a little bit of the actual stiffness and actually penetrating ability. And so that can cause some instability here in the penis. So that's where sometimes it's not a great option for everybody, but if it works for you and you like it, fantastic, you know, that's great. Again, there's multiple different options. It's really patient-centered therapy, you know, option. The best option for you is the option that we go with. The other main situation where you would use a vacuum erection device other than to participate in activities is if you have severe erectile dysfunction, that you're failing medications, maybe you haven't made a decision about what you're going to do next, you haven't been able to get back to your urologist and talk to them, or if you've recently had pelvic surgery, whether it's prostate, bladder, rectal, etc., then the reality is that those are two situations where you would use the vacuum erection device for what we call penile rehab. What is penile rehab? Again, it's that old adage, if you don't use it, you lose it. And so if the penis isn't filling up anymore, you're not stretching it out and getting stiff and maximizing the girth intermittently throughout the week, then the reality is that sometimes you'll get atrophy, sometimes you'll get shrinkage. We can't always fix that once it's happened. And so penile rehab is a way to try to proactively prevent that. Again, the vacuum erection device is a mechanical way to pull blood into the penis. Again, that blood carries nutrients and oxygen to the tissues to keep them nice and vital. And also, it's that kind of mechanical inflation and girth and stiffness that help prevent the shrinkage and atrophy. So in that setting, what you're going to want to do is basically, again, get the penis ready, lube up the skin and or the end of the vacuum erection device. Basically, you're just going to slide the little device over the top of the penis. And again, basically, you're going to, you know, inflate it, stretch it out. Again, that's going to pull blood into the penis, you know, elongate it, make it girthy as much as it normally is through your normal physiology. You're going to pull that in, leave it stretched up, leave it suctioned for up to 30 minutes, 3 to 5 times a week. The reality is you want to keep that penis as stretched out and elongated and full of blood for about 30 minutes, 3 to 5 times a week, to keep good nutrients, good blood flow getting in there, but also stretching out the tissues, maximizing those normal physiologic limits of the corpora cavernosa to make sure that you're not getting shrinkage and atrophy before you get to a functional solution for you. So those are the two main ways to use the vacuum erection device. Again, one is for activities. You use that with the penile ring. I don't think I mentioned it, but this ring really should never be on the penis for more than 30 minutes. So you can participate in activities and you can go about your business. But once you hit that 30 minute mark, you really want to make sure you take the ring off the penis, because you want to get, remember, when that's there, it's trapping blood in the penis, and that's old blood. Over time, the tissues use up the oxygen and the nutrients, and they basically won't have any more. And so that can certainly start to cause or worsen damage to the penile tissues. And so from that standpoint, 30 minutes maximum, I always want to get that ring off. Again, the other option is the penile rehab, stretching out, filling up the blood in the penis, stretching out the tissues, bringing in good oxygen, bringing in good nutrients, and stretching out the tissues to make sure you don't get shrinkage and atrophy. Again, it's that old adage, if you don't use it, you lose it. And what we hate to see as urologists, especially sexual medicine doctors, we hate to see when patients come in 2 to 3 years later, they haven't been using it because it hasn't been functional, and then there's atrophy, shrinkage, and the common complaint is, that's not how my penis used to be. We want to see you as soon as you're to the point where you're non-functional, because we want to get you on some type of therapy that makes it functional. You don't start to get shrinkage, you don't start to get atrophy, and you don't lose girth or length. Again, this is Jared J. Wallen, MD, board certified urologic surgeon and men's sexual health specialist. Check us out at unwe.com. Check out the next page for all of our links, as well as the website. And have a blessed day, folks. Thank you so much for watching our video. This is UNWE Urologic Surgery and Wellness, Recover Gentler, Sarasota, Florida. Check out our links at the bottom left-hand corner.